access to innovative medicine. It's the managed entry scheme or pay for performance or performance-based risk sharing agreement. This is the involved plan by which the performance of the product is tracked in a defined patient population over a specified period of time, and the label or continuation of reimbursement is based on the health and economic outcomes achieved. And this one mainly, it will be good for drug when there is still underdeveloped evidence that it's cost effective. So newly launched drug and you want to promote the access for this product. However, in external price referencing, we should not override the conclusion of health technology assessment or value-based pricing approaches, because this one also, it can help if you are in high-income country or in developed countries. And the practice of external price referencing should be harmonized with other pricing and reimbursement policies and programs within the country, so not to produce inconsistent pricing recommendation. And countries with value-based pricing, they have to adjust their, if they are want to use the external price referencing. So are we ready for that? We know all that using economic evaluation methodology as decision-making tools will facilitate rational patient access to medicine and to promote the equity. However, the cost effectiveness analysis and budget impact analysis, health technology assessment, value-based pricing, managed entry stream, all are examples for decision-making tools that promote access for innovative medicine and re-optimize the reimbursement decision. However, to implement that, we are facing some challenges. So Middle East countries are relatively underdeveloped in applying those methods. The infrastructure in the health system is still not ready for that. And there are barriers to use economic evaluation are existing. So here we have a study published from Asia about using economic evaluation. So it is mission impossible or mission probable. So this is one of the, in this study, it's categorizing the barriers to using the economic evaluation in under two main strands. One is the production of the economic information, and other one is related to the decision context-related barriers. So the setting-related issues and the poor quality of evidence, unbiased study, and delay adoption, and also the decision-maker may prefer local studies rather than using or adjusting study in other setting, and the economic evaluation, lack of economic evaluation guideline. Decision context-related barriers is the lack of understanding of economic evaluation among healthcare professionals and decision-makers. And this is, it was proving in this study. And also, a politics issue, where is the power? I mean, decision-maker, they would like to have the power of purchasing, the procurement, the reimbursement, while they don't want to transfer this power to the health economist or the academia or the HTA center. And also, there is other philosophical and cultural ethical consideration, like even it's cost-effective study for young, they want to, because they respect the elderly in the Asia, this is what they reflect that. And also, it's, there is a lack of standardization of economic evaluation method. So in conclusion to this presentation, external price referencing is a good method to control unpatent pharmaceutical prices if it's applying the key principles to promote fair pricing and equitable access to health technologies and improving the sustainability of pricing practices that encourage innovation. Selecting reference countries with similar economic status and health objectives will increase the likelihood of having appropriate prices. Prices developed within, using external price referencing should not override the conclusion of health technology assessment. And more research is needed in the Middle East. And there is a need to use economic evaluation methods as decision-making tools. Barriers are existing, and we need to conduct research in Middle East region to set the barrier if it's similar to the example from Asia. And academia, regional ESMOR chapters has an important role in capacity building, training and education, in developing and implementing external price referencing and health technology assessment good practice in the MENA region. And in the UAE, the quality healthcare service and capacity building are the top of the UAE government agenda, and favorable regulatory environment, it's accelerate the rational access to innovative medicine. The GCC price harmonization definitely will promote the access to innovative drug within high-income countries in the GCC. I mean, Yemen is included in the GCC, but I don't think it will get much benefit from these prices. They are eligible for lower prices. And independent research to assess and evaluate key attributes and barriers in drug use, prescribing trends, and current policies in the UAE, GCC, and MENA region is required. Joint, of course, and collaboration among stakeholders, including the industry and the patient group, to develop and implement related policies, setting strategies and action plan, are the key driver to promote the rational access to the medicines with a sustainable quality pricing system and value-driving healthcare system in the region, in order to enhance related regulation and policies using economic evaluation formally. This is it's very important, and also in capacity building. Yesterday, Dr. Walker, he asked us what you suggest if I ask you one question, what we need now. Yes, capacity building, I believe it's the most important issues currently in the health technology and pharmacoeconomics and economic evaluation in the region is required. So thank you for listening.
Thank you very much indeed, Dr. Al-Hada. Very interesting and stimulating talk in terms of looking at the practicality of external price referencing in the Middle East and the unique policies that is required to highlight that. Now we're going to move on straight to our next presentation, which will be the last presentation you'll be delighted to know before our well-deserved break. It's a great pleasure to introduce Dr. Mohammed Al-Rubai. Dr. Rubai is the Director of Drug Control in the Director General of Pharmaceutical Affairs and Drug Control of Ministry of Health in Oman. He's also a member of the GC Central Registration Committee, joined the Ministry of Health in 1998, founding member of the Oman Pharmaceutical Society, and I believe the first chair of the Pharmaceutical Society 2010 and 2011. And I'm also delighted to say that he received his PhD from Cardiff University, and Professor Walker and myself had the pleasure of supervising him. It's a great pleasure to be here.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Thank you, Prof. Sam, and thank you for the organizer. Thank you for Dr. Liam for inviting me to talk to you today, actually, about an important project at GCC in the last 3 years. My presentation will be about the implementation of the GCC price harmonization process. The agenda of my presentation.
Check our projector.
I don't know my sound coming, but
anyway.
First of all, GCC pharmaceutical market. Secondly, GCC healthcare expenditure. GCC price harmonization background. And the reason behind the price harmonization, steps to price harmonization challenges, And finally, conclusions. GCC healthcare expenditure, growing population, and alongside also the strong government support for healthcare are expected to drive the expansion of regional pharma industry. According to Economics Intelligence Unit, the GCC population will reach around 53 million by 2020. Because of the lifestyle, actually, you know, this increase in obesity, cases of diabetes, cardiovascular disease, this will create a tremendous demand of healthcare in GCC. The GCC healthcare system listed around 65 infrastructural projects, which is worth around $33 billion in 2013. For example, in Oman, we announced 2013 a new or first medical health center, which is cost around $1.5 billion, an area around 5 million square meter, and I have the expectation within the implementation within like the next 5 years, starting with the pre-med hospital, Orange transplant hospital, pediatric hospital, and trauma center. Governmental healthcare expenditure. times created in Bahrain, followed by UAE, then Saudi Arabia.
Profit margin actually.
example, between 33 and around 33 in Saudi Arabia to 55% in Oman. The next step is the implementing of a price unit within the Gulf Corporation Council for pricing. This in 2012 also. Minister of Health also approved the budget for the unit as well as needed human resources. Forming GCC pricing committee with a two representative from each country. The first thing starting with this pricing committee to prepare the guidelines for pricing of medicines, preparing a data bank for price information between the different GCC countries. Normally they are meeting this committee every two months. They're comparing the difference GCC price per product and taking the cheapest price between them. They decide to start as a first stage with the branded product. Once the price agreed, a communication to the company would be made, giving them 2 months for appeal, which should be supported by the comments or the supported documents. They find the GCC office inform the company about the approved price. Actually, they start the pricing committee with the five therapeutic groups of medicines, and which announced, for example, the one who announced it in October 2014. The therapeutic groups are cardiovascular system products, endocrine system products, musculoskeletal system products, skin preparation, and GIT system preparation. The rest of the 10 groups are finished and expecting to be implemented within the next 2 to 3 months by the GCC countries. In Oman, we announced that in the implementation will be in the 1st of July 2015. The process is still ongoing and going on, and any country who reduces their price nationally for any reason would bring that to the note of the committee, where a repricing process may take place. They may take the price and maybe not. It's depend upon the discussion in the committee actually. What's the parameters used for pricing by the GCC pricing committee? The pharmaceutical company, they must submit a certificate, include the retail price of product in the country of origin, the EX factory price of product in the country of origin, the wholesale price, the seed price given for GCC country in USD, product price and some international reference source, the list of 31 countries where the product is registered, price and sold, the price of product in each GCC country, the price of other similar group of medicine if available. This is some examples of the medicine which is priced, and the prices in Oman. The Oman price in comparison with the new reduced price, which is approved by the GCC pricing committee. You can see, for example, Levix is annual consumption per bag is around 6,290. The old price is 37 Omani riyal, the reduced price is around 32 Omani riyal, difference 4.55 Omani riyal. The value of Omani riyal, saving value is around 28.619, and saving USD is $74,000. You can see for Galfas, 50 milligram, 14,000 bag, around 15,000 bag. The old price is 18 riyal. The new price, you can see the big difference here. It's 88 riyal, the new price. The difference is 9.38 riyal. The can see also for others, the total products mentioned by Dr. Bawazir, this is for 20 products, and you can see the total saving in around 1 million, around 1,500,000 Oman Riyal. Now, the price harmonization challenges in the GCC. Actually, still it's not clear for what will be the size and the scope of the ongoing harmonization reform. For example, what's the next step? Is there any pricing will be for the generic? It's still under discussion by the GCC country. Implementation of the new prices by all GCC countries. And actually, the timeline for implementation different from one country to other country. And this is maybe because of, like I said, regarding political or economical reason in each country. Also, the profit margin is not exceeding 45%. Until now, there's a difference between the GCC country. In Oman, still it's 55% for the profit margin. Some country already they introduced a new margin. In Oman, still Minister of Health they sent the proposal to the cabinet, and Minister of Health waiting the final approval from the cabinet. Actually, the new prices implementation by the pharmaceutical companies still some companies they are appealing to the committee or you know. Revising the price by the committee, some negative response from the committee regarding reducing the prices. Then the company again, they send to the countries. That means if the country can do something to reduce, revise the price, but actually the country therefore forward this to the committee. It's like a dilemma for certain products. This is also affecting the availability of the, some medicine actually. Still, the GCC country watching the situation of the availability of the products. Also, another challenge is the local registration and different timelines. Because the new products, if it's registered, for example, Oman, or Bahrain, or UAE, they register the product and they give the company a price.
Okay, Mary.
Finally, timeline in Saudi Arabia to take more time. Okay. If the product is registered in Saudi Arabia and they give it reduced price, then again the price are going to the registration committee to reducing the price as per the lowest price in Saudi Arabia. In a conclusion. And the ultimate aim behind unifying the medicines across the GCC was to reduce the cost of medicine for the patients. Significant price reduction for medicine across the GCC country is going forward. Significant price reduction on drug would have far-reaching implications in the launch sequence optimization, since different countries have different registration timelines. And finally, there's no doubt that harmonization of the prices in GCC would improve affordability, but only time can improve the availability and sustainability of the medicines. Thank you very much.
Since the Saudi has got this very high purchasing power, is the negotiation that goes on between Saudi and companies, is that transparent? Do you let other GCC countries know what price you have negotiated?
We are living now for, you know, we have this centralized procedure for registration. And now most of innovative product actually is registered. Most of the cases. So then we are actually pushing for centralized procedure rather than peripheral procedures.
So that's the future. Now the two papers are open for discussion and question, please. The gentleman there. on the microphone.
First of all, thank you very much for all the presenters for their valuable presentations and information. I am Ihab Kamel, Market Access Director for AMFI and for the Gulf region. My question is regarding the pricing, and as Dr. Rubeyi and Dr. Ola also mentioned, the GCC price unification, which I believe we are at the unified all over the GCC countries currently. So the point is, individually in the countries, there are re-registration or renewal of re-registration. And with this one, it triggered the price certificate to be submitted to authorities. So in this case, if it happened like at the different timelines, as you said, as you mentioned, this will trigger again a price certification all over the GCC countries.
No, no.
pricing experience at your countries. Actually, I have one small question to Dr. Lala regarding the ASPR chapter that you have in your country. Since you are the head of the ASPR chapter at your country, I just want to ask one question. How effective is the ASPR chapter at your country? And what's the experience that you gained from the ASPR participation in setting up the rules of pricing at your country? Thank you.
Thank you for your questions. Yes, it's a critical question because we want in the region to work. In our region, we have lack of information about health economics and pharmacoeconomics. And one of the major things we focus on is to promote the awareness about this discipline. Okay. What we did in the UAE in this since the inception in 2009, the ASPR chapter, after I returned back from my PhD study, is to promote the awareness, to build capacity, and that's what we did in the first place. We start with a few members, now we have more than 50 members, and I can say 80% of those members are very active and supporting the objectives of this chapter. Okay, we organize many workshops, many conferences, plus include the pharmacoeconomics in many universities for undergraduate and for postgraduate as core subject. As well, we are now developing pharmacoeconomics guideline for the UAE. The draft is almost ready, and we suppose maybe we have to meet another meeting among the chapter to finalize or fine-tuning that guideline. One of the key issues that the representation of ASPR chapter in the ASPR meeting, I mean every year there is ASPR conference meeting in the US, it's from 15 or 16 May, after a few days, till 21 in Philadelphia in the US. So in this ASPR, we have representation for the Arab network. Arab network, it's include the 7 chapter participate in the survey, plus 2 chapter they jointly announced. It's from Algeria and from Tunisia, also they will join us. So we have their forum always for this. We present about topic, related topic, about the progress of the pharmacoeconomics and health economics in the region. And also we have always meeting there for all the Arab network. We work together now. The first initiative was translation of the ASPR book of terms to Arabic language. We know all the scientific language is English. However, there is some certain terms maybe not very obvious or clear for normal, for Christian graduate student or like this. So we translated to Arabic, and now it's in the final stage for linguistic review. So, and that survey, which we, I covered in my presentation, it's one of the initiatives under the Arabic network and this one. So this is in brief, and I encourage all participants from other, and in Kuwait also last year or before 2 years, it's there is ASPR chapter, there is Dr. Hamad Sultan from Kuwait and Dr. Mariam Rawesh, they are also from ASPR chapter, they participate in the survey. And Egypt chapter very active as well. They also have developed their guideline. They are leading in this issue. And Dr. Amr yesterday elaborated how they incorporate their pharmacoeconomics economics unit in the Ministry of Health. And I believe this is very good step forward in Egypt. I wish to issue recommendation at MENA region, at Arab League, at GCC level, to conduct and have HTA center for the GCC or the MENA region. So because we are lacking of expertise, so individual country cannot have power or the capability to establish independent HTA center. So I believe it's the right time to go forward with recommendation to establish such center and to promote building capacity in all the region, as well to start the research. We are lacking more research. Like now I use a study from Asia. We need to conduct our own study to assist the pricing system, the real world environment for the access to innovative medicine and essential medicine. So it's one of the essential requirements in this stage. Thank you.
I think Dr. Rolla's message is very clear. The collaboration between academia, regulators, and other scientific organizations on education, training, and capacity building. Now, I think we need to stop here. I'll allow just the last question. But I just wanted to ask Dr. Rabai, is there still time regarding the harmonization that we could have some baseline data of the speed with which the patient has access to medicine, new medicine, and how it's going to be under the government system? Would the patient access to new medicine be going to be improved?
I am sure that the affordability of medicine, it will increase. And this is between the GCT country actually, okay. Follow up regarding the availability of medicine in the country. And there's a science actually, but we started the new prices, for example, for the new groups from the last October. Until now, we don't face any problem regarding the availability. But the problem here, and maybe in the last presenter, they mentioned about certain mature products, and this is what we are facing not in the Gulf, actually, worldwide. Professor Bowser, he mentioned about warfare, for example. I can give you a list of 100 products which is not available in the market, and we compete with the company. Is there a problem in the prices of this medicine? Their answer is no, this is a marketing strategy. The problem is no alternative available. And the generic companies, they're not manufacturing that product. The country, they are facing a problem. The availability is not always related to the price of medicine. I hope that the company, pharmaceutical company, doing something regarding this. I think it's not only a business, it's also a service, on the other hand. All that the health authority and the company, they are serving the patients. But there must be like a balance between the marketing and the service to the patients. I don't know if there is some recommendation from even this conference, but I think we need to emphasize regarding the availability of some of the mature products that must be available in the markets.
I think that's a very important point, it's a very challenging one. We're going to go to a very quick question and a quick answer.
We know that expenditure representing 14 to 20% out of the whole expenditure. Any plans for unification, other services like doctor's fees and something like the DRGs, for example, across the GCC to be matching with the price harmonization?
As I know, I don't know about it actually, because this is other part. I don't know, Professor Bowazir, if you have any answer for this. I don't think there's any discussion about unification of the doctor fee?
I can comment on that. This is related how the health insurance system will be implemented in the all countries. So if the health insurance system be implemented in the whole GCC or Middle East country, maybe at that time we can think about it. But currently it's patchy, the implementation, and it's not fully covered in all. That's my opinion, personal opinion, yeah, about the DRG, about the using of ICD-10 or IMI. So this is all is related to later on, and about the doctor fees. However, in our survey, it's showing there is wide variation between other non-pharmaceutical services, while in pharmaceutical is one narrow corridor in the pricing among the seven countries. So I do agree with you, there is variation. However, variation between different income countries is acceptable. But is it within the same, like, high-income country? It's not justified.
I think we have to leave it there. Thank you so much for your participation. We're going to have a 30-minute break. And if I could have you back here, 12:45, please. And hopefully we'll catch up on the lost time and we finish for lunch of the time that is already in the schedule. Now we're going to come back and we're going to start with Dr. David Danko, who is going to tell us all about the opportunities of pragmatic health technology assessment. So we'll see you all here in 30 minutes, please.
Break.
Dr. Danko is going to build on that. Now, Dr. Danko, in a way of introduction, is a managing director of Ideas and Solutions in Budapest, Hungary. He's a research leader in Corvinus University of Budapest, and he has had 12 years of experience in healthcare management and financing, and he focuses on reimbursement policy and market access. And until 2010, he was the deputy head of the Department of Reimbursement in Hungary. And he has co-edited a book on pharmaceutical reimbursement. And now, of course, he's working on his PhD. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure to introduce Dr. David Danko.
Which do not
these approaches take several dimensions, and they try to assess the drug according to these dimensions, and then they put the medicine into a certain category or assign a certain score to this type of to the aspect, okay, to the medicine. I'm going to show you a couple of examples of countries which apply a similar paradigm. And then, of course, there is a combination of the two where we try to quantify health benefits and costs, but we, in a very structured framework, try to put or try to give a different, say, or incorporate other